This week, I've been playing Educandy, and my students love it. And for me as a teacher, it's great because it's really easy to get set up and make activities and share them with my students. So I'm going to show you in this video how I've been using it this week and how you can use it too. So when we visit the Educandy website, the first thing we need to do is download one of these apps. So we've got Educandy Play or Educandy Studio. If we are the teacher or the educator here, we would add the Educandy Studio app to your phone, your tablet, or your desktop. If you are a student, then you would choose the Educandy Play. You can access the games via the website though. So for example, you can see at the top here, we can choose an activity code and we can join the game via the website. So to download the apps, let's say as the teacher, we would just click on this and we would choose get it from Microsoft. Once we're at the Microsoft store, all we need to do is just press get or obtener in Spanish. Then we would add this to our computer. And then on the start menu, you can see at the top here, I have already installed Educandy Play and Educandy Studio. So here we have the variety of games that we can play with our students. We've got Wordsearch, Noughts and Crosses, Crosswords, Spell It, which is a version of Hangman, you know, Hangman. Just joking. Anagrams, matchup, multiple choice, and memory games. So once you've downloaded the Educandy Studio, you just need to register here. I've already made an account, so I'm gonna pop it in here. I'm gonna put my password in. Can you just look away for a second? You're still looking. So once we're on the app, we come to the home screen. We can see a list of all the activities that we've created. If we go to the top right-hand corner, we've got the menu, my account, create a new activity, upgrade to a premium plan, or the best thing, which is to search for activities or to search for community-created resources that are ready for the classroom. So let's say we want to create a new activity. So we just go to new activity here. And in this app, there are three types of activities. There's words, matching pairs, or quiz questions. If we do a word task, then we get to choose between these three activities here. If we do a matching pairs activity, then we get to choose between these four. And finally, if we do a quiz question, then we only get to choose the multiple choice style activity. Okay, so let's say we want to do a word activity. So we click on words. Let's say I'm making a review of food vocabulary. Food vocabulary. Activity subject is English. Click on create. And here we can begin adding the words we'd like to include. So banana, add word, melon, strawberry, and apple. So now we've got at least three entries, so we can now start playing. We click on details to add some optional instructions for the students, or we just go directly to play to test it. So for example, we had four words. So if we go to word search, we're gonna see the four words on the right hand side, and we're gonna have to find the four words within this word search. Let's see if we can find one. So I've already found melon at the top here, so we just hold down and pull across, and we have that selected. We want to test spell it. We can click on this one here. Okay, I think this one, no, it's not apple. Melon. Okay, and we just go to next to do the next word. And let's test the anagrams. This is melon, of course. And it keeps giving us the next word and the next word until we have completed all the words. Now, if I wanted to play this in class together as a group, I would just click on play. But if I want to share this with my students so they can play in their own time or perhaps on their own devices, then I would click share. And you can see here that we have a link and a code here. Now this code is linked directly to the food vocabulary activity that I've created. If the students go to the Educandy Play app, they can use this code to play this food activity. And here you can see that the student has arrived now at the food vocabulary game, and they can choose word search, hangman, or anagrams. Let's say they choose anagrams, and the students are going to play exactly the same game that we just tested earlier. If they want to go back and play a different kind of game, they can press the arrow key on the left hand side and choose a different one here. If the students don't have the app, then they can also go to the educandy.com website and just pop the code into the top right hand corner here. add the code, press play, and again, here we have the same activities. So how would I use these word activities with my students? Well, I teach a lot of young learners, so we do spend a lot of time in class making sure they get the correct spelling of new vocabulary we're learning. And giving them these activities really drills home how each word is spelled. And so I find this really helps in the long run when we have to review vocabulary and to make sure that they get the right spelling. So the next activity we can create are the matching pairs. And again, like the words, this is really easy to set up. All you need to do is give your activity a name, click create. Now we can only add text in the free version of this app. If you'd like to add image and sound, then you'd need to upgrade to premium. If you upgrade to premium, it's gonna cost you £3 a month or £20 per year. So all we do is click on text, and we can add the question and then the answer and create a pair. Now you need to create at least 9 or 10 pairs if you're gonna be able to play any of the games that are on offer. So for example, a typical activity with this is translating one language into another. So food in Spanish would be comida, and we press add pair. And on the right hand side, it would then list all the pairs you created. The question here and in green the answer. Now with words, it was restricted to probably only spelling of words, but with the pair activity you can start to branch into areas like getting students to think about definitions of words or even translating one language to another. I personally use this with vocabulary that we've learned and with definitions. I get the students to think about what is the meaning of the words and how they can explain the word to a partner, very similar to the taboo game that we play a lot with our students. The third and final activity that we can create on this app is the quiz questions. Again, we give it a name, click create, and as we can see, the premium options of image and sound are locked off. So if we click on those, we get presented with this message. So to create a text question, we just write the question here and we have the correct answer first and then the three alternatives or the red herrings. And here we would put the incorrect answers. We can have anywhere between one incorrect answer or three. We add this question and we'd need then to create at least three to play. Now, if you use Kahoot or quizzes, then you're probably familiar with multiple choice quiz style activities. One of the ways that I've been using this activity with my students is getting them to think about synonyms for words. So one of the things I did was to give them the question as a word and provide four options, one of them which was a synonym for this original word and three that weren't. This is particularly useful for students to start building their range of vocabulary. Now with the free version, you can only create up to 10 activities. So if you find that you're getting close to 10 or you have 10 already and you'd like to delete one or two, then all you need to do is check this box here and click delete selected item. Now I'm sure you don't have time to be creating all of these activities from scratch and you're probably going to do what I did. So I'm going to show you now how we can search for activities that are ready to be used in the classroom. So here we are on the home screen again. We're going to go to the top right hand corner and click on search activities. Let's put in a search term like food. And when we have the results, we need to pay close attention to the icons that accompany each activity title. So the green icon of a book, this means it's a word activity. The jigsaw with the red icon, this is a pair activity. And if we find the yellow icon with the four options, this is the quiz activity. Once you've chosen one, we select it and we get presented with the three options to play the game. And if you notice, in the top right hand corner, we also have the code that we can share with our students. We can also click on share game in the bottom right hand corner. And here we get presented with a link. So if you're using a learning platform like Google Classroom or Class Dojo, then this is great as well because we can copy this link and this will send the students directly to the activity. So now that you've seen how easy it is to use Educandy, from the creation of the activities to sharing them with your students and even playing them, why not get your students to create accounts on the Studio app and get creating their own activities for the rest of the class? I think one of the best features about this app is obviously the bank of resources that we can use ready to go, and also just again how simple it is to use. It is a bit restricted in terms of the feedback you can get from the activities you're playing, as there are no reports like we might see in Kahoot or quizzes. If you do want to see how the students are getting on, then I'd recommend playing it in class altogether. Thank you for watching this video, and I hope you enjoy playing Educandy with your students. If you do start creating activities and you'd like to share them, then why not comment below with a link so that the other teachers that are following my channel can play them with their students.